Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Organisms and Environment. In that, we are studying topic Commensalism. When I say commensalism, in this, one organism is benefited another. What happens to another organism? Let's see. Today we'll be studying about commensalism. Commensalism. Now this is a very unique type of interaction in animal kingdom. When I talk about commensalism, in this type of interaction, what happens is one organism is fully benefited, whereas another organism is neither harmed nor benefited. What do we mean by that? Neither harmed nor benefited. An example of this could be sea anemone and jelly glowfish. Now both these are marine animals or animals which live under the bed water. Sea anemones is something which looks like octopus. It has a lot of tentacles or hands, you can see. Whereas your glowfish or jellyfish is just a small fish living under the seabed. So whenever glowfish is under the fear of being eaten or being harmed, it comes under the hands or tentacles of sea anemones and just hides in there and gets survived or sustain itself. Whereas in return, the sea anemone is never interested in eating the glowfish. So in this case, the sea anemone, or you can say, is neither benefited nor harmed, but the glowfish is definitely benefited. It has survived the situation. Another example would be epiphytes that grows on certain trees. Now these epiphytes, when they grow on orchids or any such trees, are always in commensalism relationship. Commensalism, the type of association in which relationship between both organisms is seen and one organism is benefited, while to another organism neither harm nor benefit takes place. So you can say one species takes the whole advantage of the whole situation, while another one just calms down. An example of this could be sea anemone and glowfish. Another example in kingdom plantae of this would be orchids, which grow on epiphytic plants. Now they provide support, but in return they never get anything. Students, this was commensalism, in which one is benefited and to another gains nothing or gets nothing in hand in return. I hope y'all are clear about this concept of commensalism. Thank you.